Thank you. Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Mr. Secretary General, Prime Minister Trudeau, Prime Minister Holness, first of all, I want to thank you for initiating this conference because this is, as we all know, a global issue. It's a global problem and it needs a global solution. So let me just start off by saying that when the virus hit Pakistan and we did the lockdown, everything came to a standstill, as it did in most economies of the world, where they were trying to cope with the stopping the spread of the coronavirus. And when everything came to a standstill, the biggest issue for us was how to look after the most vulnerable section of our population. And the people affected in the non-formal sector of our economy, we in our country, out of a population of 220 million people, the vulnerable section of the society was almost 150 million people. Non-formal sector, daily wages, weekly wages, whose family depended upon them earning money so that they could eat. So we then started this big cash handout, one of the biggest programs in Pakistan's history. We doled out $8 billion to stimulate our economy, and of course to give cash to the most vulnerable section of our society. But the problem was, and the problem is, we have falling exports. We have falling remittances. We were trying to big, ambitious plans to revive our tourism sector. All this took a nosedive. And I know that this is the problem with most of the countries, but specifically the developing countries face this problem. To put things in perspective, the total amount of stimulus we could afford to give to our economy, and that was the biggest stimulus ever in our history, we managed to give $8 billion. And so when you compare it with countries like the United States, from what I heard, they're giving $3 trillion, Germany $1 trillion, euros, Japan $1 trillion, the developing world, we calculated, has given $7 trillion to stimulate the economy. And when you compare that with the developing world, unfortunately, we do not have the fiscal space to revive our economy, to look after the most vulnerable section of our society. And in case of our country, we still have this huge, ambitious program of fighting climate change by planting 10 billion trees. So all this money got diverted into dealing with the effects of the coronavirus lockdown. So all I want to say is that it is very important for the developing world to, at this critical juncture, look after the people of the developing world, which are struggling. When I spoke to the prime ministers of Ethiopia, of the president of Egypt, prime minister of Nigeria, all of them are facing similar problems to what we are facing. And therefore, I really welcome the G20 for taking this big initiative of giving debt relief. But bear in mind, this really has to be thought through. This stimulus, this help to the developing world, I'm afraid has to be much bigger than so far it has been envisaged. Because, you know, you have the developing world, but 1.5 billion people. You have, the developed world, but you're the developing world with a population of 6 billion people. Unless the problem is dealt with holistically as a global problem, with global solutions, The world is not going to recover from this recession if the bigger part of the world's population is wallowing into poverty. So therefore, I again, Mr. Secretary General, I congratulate you. I think this is again a great initiative. I want to, again, Prime Minister Trudeau, to you and the Jamaican Prime Minister, again, I want to say that this is, please pursue these initiatives. It is very important that the world, which became insular when the when COVID-19 hit the world, it's very important that the world now looks at this whole issue globally. And therefore, I'm sure if the developed countries put their minds together and treat this as a global situation, I think that we will all come out of it unscathed. Right now, things look bleak, but I think if we deal it as a global issue, I think that the world will come out of it. Thank you very much.